If we want to select any trade, just click on any order, okay, and then press shift plus click, so it will select my orders. So here I got 3 orders selected and I can manage them, okay, like all selected orders. So here I have selected these orders and I can close them. So there you can see my selected orders were closed, okay. And if I want to select any of single order, okay, then just press control and then select for single orders, okay. For selecting multiple orders, just press shift plus click, okay, and then it will select multiple orders. So in this way we can manage our trades with the help of shift and control also. Now we will see how we can get details of any order, okay. To get details of any order, we will click here on the ticket number, or we will click here in the toolbox and then we will go to edit, okay. And there you can see we can get details of our ticket number, okay. Similarly we will click here, okay. We can also manage our trade parameters here. We can adjust our stop loss, like here you can see fixed price, pips, fixed cash risk. You can manage your risk, okay, and you can set your stop loss to break even also. And here we have also option of closing our trade, okay. And similarly we can set trailing stop to our trade also, like in terms of pips, so it will give us option of setting trailing stop, okay. So here you can see now 20 pips trailing stop has been adjusted in our trade. We can close our trade also and we can see floating profit or loss, okay. So in this way we can get details of ticket number. Now here you can see a little bit red icon below the toolbox. It is showing us that our trailing stop is near to be hit, okay. It is showing us our trailing stop is very very near. Just we will click here and we will see what is going on. It is showing us task in progress. So, and trailing stop is being run on ticket 20 pips, okay. This red icon, this one is showing us trailing stop is being run on this ticket 20 pips. So in this way we can get details of our trades. Now we will see another important thing in this lecture, and that is automated closes, okay. What is automated closes? Basically this is designed to create some more parameters, like it is showing that applies one or more rules for closing our trades, okay. So we can get here when our trade is in profit in pips greater or equal to, okay, we can set percentage, we can set our stop loss, and similarly we can apply or remove our stop loss, take profit, and we can set our email alarm, and we can apply rules, and we can save template also. So in this way we can manage and get new template with the help of automated closing, okay. Now we will take a look what is OCA. Basically OCA is that one cancels all. So for example we have lot of multiple pending orders. When our one of our pending order is triggered, then all of our next pending orders will be deleted, okay. A group where all of our remaining automatically orders are deleted when one of the order is filled, okay. And similarly next one is order summary. In order summary we can get summary of open position by symbol or direction, duration, etc, okay. And it is giving us a floating window which is containing aggregated information about the orders and their profitability, such in cash, pips, and their total volume also, okay. So OCA is one cancels all, a group where all the remaining orders are deleted when one of them is filled or triggered. And in the order summary, we can get details of all of our trades. Now we will see OCA at the terminal. Okay, at trade terminal, one cancels all. So here we can create a group. When one of our trade will be triggered, then other will be deleted automatically. So for this, just click here, and here you can see create OCA group or delete OCA group. For creating OCA group, just click here. As you can see, I have two pending orders here, buy limit EURUSD and buy limit AUDUSD. Okay, so I will click there and I will name it like Euro. Okay, and then I will click on create OCA group. Okay, so now my OCA group has been created. Okay, so whenever our OCA group is created, then you will see a little red option will be created here. Okay, after creating the OCA group, here we got a new red option. Okay, and we can check it also in the ticket box that this ticket is part of an OCA group. Okay, hit ticket number, and here you can see our buy limit. Okay, so in this way you can check your OCA group has been created or not. It will give us a little red option here. Okay, now next one is order summary. Basically it is giving us summary of the open and pending orders. Okay, and by clicking here we will get a new menu of summary. We can get it from symbol, duration, direction. Okay, long and short, symbol plus direction, magic number, winning and losing trade. Okay, all of these according to the time also. So for example, here I will choose symbol. Here you can see a new window has been opened which is showing us floating profit or loss and pips with volume also. It is telling us that our trade is in buy or sell. Okay, and again we can carry out any of action which we were discussing earlier. Okay, here like we can partially close, we can close them, we can set stop loss, take profit, break even, etc. Okay, so in this way we can get a new window from the order summary. So basically order summary is telling a summary of open position according to their symbol, direction, duration, etc. And it gives us a floating window which is giving us information of the symbol. Okay, and in the loss we have option of settings. Okay, we can control settings of our trade terminal just by clicking here. Okay, and here we will get confirmation and preferences and unlock terminal. Just by clicking here in confirmation, you can see we can add or delete confirmation. For example, when we will get any new entry, then we can get option of confirmation again. Okay, and confirmation for closing all of the trades. Okay, so in this way we can manage our settings. Okay, so this was the explanation that how trade terminal is going to help us in our bad trading. This is very very important. I have tried my best to explain all of these parameters of trade terminal. Okay, all of these options of trade terminals with full explanation, with full details. Okay, and still if you have any query and still if you have any ambiguity, you can ask me here and then I will explain it to you. Okay, trade terminal is very very important for managing of the trades, for getting alarms, for market watch and order summaries, for closing the trades, setting stop loss, take profit. Okay, so this was the explanation of trade terminal. I'm sure that now you have full concept of it. Okay, thank you so much.